I'll give my prediction in a little while on the AJ Andy Ruiz fight. I just seen the Dillion White Marius Wach fight. Both fighters didn't look that great, but Marius Wach looked a little better to me in this fight. Better combinations. He was using the jab a little better. But what can I say, man? Marius Wach ain't no walkover, man. I was the first guy to stop Marius Wach. I beat him with one hand, basically. The same elbow. I hurt my elbow in that training camp getting ready for Marius Wach. And I was seeing elbow I was dealing with towards the AJ camp. It was a good fight. It was an entertaining fight. But like I said, man, Marius Wach ain't no pushover. You clearly see that. I beat him with one hand at the lightest weight that I was in the last 3 or 4 years. Not the most effective weight, but at my lightest weight. So if I'd have fought Marius Wach at my normal 300, I'd have probably stopped him earlier. So that should tell you, Marius Wach ain't no pushover. And Dillion White went the distance. And it wasn't even 12 rounds. What's up? I'll give my prediction in a little while on the AJ Andy Ruiz fight. I just seen the Dillion White Marius Wach fight. Both fighters didn't look that great, but Marius Wach looked a little better to me in this fight. Better combinations. He was using the jab a little better. But what can I say, man? Marius Wach ain't no walkover, man. I was the first guy to stop Marius Wach. I beat him with one hand, basically. The same elbow. I hurt my elbow in that training camp getting ready for Marius Wach. And I was seeing elbow I was dealing with towards the AJ camp. It was a good fight. It was an entertaining fight. But like I said, man, Marius Wach ain't no pushover. You clearly see that. I beat him with one hand at the lightest weight that I was in the last 3 or 4 years. Not the most effective weight, but at my lightest weight. So if I'd have fought Marius Wach at my normal 300, I'd have probably stopped him earlier. So that should tell you, Marius Wach ain't no pushover.